Witam po raz dziewiąty z tej strony Poliglos, and in this video we'll be talking about aunt verbs, not to be confused with aunts, which belongs to the previous verb type. Aunt verbs are also, in my opinion, suspicious verbs, only instead they're hiding an N or more rarely an M, and take the exact same e, o endings as the other suspicious verbs, palatalization and all. Since M stem only applies rarely, let's talk about those verbs first. The verb donch, to blow, of the wind, or to play a wind instrument, like a trompka, a trumpet, has a stem in dm, giving us dmę w trompkę, I blow on the trumpet, dmię w trompkę, he, she, it blows on the trumpet, and dmą w trompkę, they blow on the trumpet. Similarly, verbs with the stem jąć have stems in jm, I don't know how to pronounce that, take przyjąć, to take or accept, which becomes przyjmę, I will take, przyjmie, he, she, it will take, and przyjmą, they will take. In some cases, you might come across something called the mobile E, which is an E that appears in certain cases to ease pronunciation. Take the word zdjąć, to take off, as in clothes. If we try to conjugate it as per our little rule, we get zdmę? How do you even pronounce that? This is where the mobile E comes to the rescue, giving us zdejmę. I will take off, and by extension, zdejmie, he, she, it will take off, and zdejmą, they will take off. Similarly, wziąć, which actually comes from jąć, prefixed with wz, and is slightly irregular, but all the while worth discussing here, conjugates as wezmę, weźmie, and wezmą. We have the same endings and the mobile e, it's just the z that palatalizes with the m. In most other cases, though, it's n. Take miąć, to crumple or bend, a meme as of recent Polish exams, which conjugates mnę, I crumple, mnie, he, she, it crumples, and mną, they crumple. If the verb ends in nąć, very common, mind you, then you don't need to add another n. So zepchnąć, to push off, conjugates as zepchnę, I will push off, zepchnie, he, she, it will push off, and zepchną, they will push off. In cases such as ciąć, to cut, the soft consonant, in this case ch, depalatalizes to the hard t. Tnę, I cut, tnie, he, she, it cuts, tną, they cut. This also applies to miąć, but isn't obvious in orthography, as m and mie are written with the same letter. Because of clusters that form at the beginning, like tnę is already hard enough to say, prefixed verbs may need the mobile e again. So zgiąć, to fold, from z and giąć, doesn't conjugate as zgnę, because ugh, but instead zegnę, I will fold, and thus zegnie, he, she, it will fold, and zegną, they will fold. A more extreme example would be ściąć, to cut off. It's not that evident, but it's actually ciąć, to cut, from earlier, prefixed with z. It's only written sz to reflect pronunciation, but with the mobile e, the z comes back to its original pronunciation. Zetnę, I will cut off, zetnie, he, she, it will cut off, and zetnął, they will cut off. As opposed to stnę or stnie, I have no idea. Anyway, crikey, that was almost, if not as dense as the last part. We've just got irregulars left, which I've left at the end, even though they include some of the more common verbs, so I'll see you there.